Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we have with us Gautam Navlakha. We know Kashmir was always pegged that it will play a crucial role before the 2019 elections in shaping the narrative before the 2019 elections. BJP will use it in one way or the other to for an advantage for itself. But now seeing the recent losses BJP has suffered in state assembly elections where it was supposed to have a stronghold, how do you think Kashmir will be used now?
There are two things I'd like to point out here. One is how Kashmir would be used also depends on how India uses Pakistan's bogey. It is a bogey as far as I'm concerned, because we allow government of India successfully through their misgovernance and misrule provides opportunities for outsiders to fish in troubled waters. So we have to take primary responsibility for that situation. But they'll continue to use Pakistan as a bogey. This is what we are doing. We want to deny indigenous character of this movement by saying it's all proxy driven. It's all being done by Pakistan. I mean, it would be, I think enough has been said on this, if that after 70 years, government of India claims that Pakistan can play such a fish in troubled waters at its whim and desire, then it shows our own government in poor light. Let's leave that aside for the time being. What role would Kashmir play in Jammu and Kashmir? Historically, Jammu and Kashmir was one of the three pillars of RSS policy. And so-called integration or assimilation of Jammu and Kashmir into Indian Union was a prime target objective of the RSS. They have tried to play that card. But if you read carefully the election results in the local body elections in Jammu, where participation was much higher, and definitely there was much greater enthusiasm there and in Ladakh, outside Chenab Valley especially, where people participated in large number, you'll notice that the BJP's graph has actually gone down. So there is not the takers for BJP's line of argument or RSS line of argument of a tough policy of teaching Pakistan a lesson have all rebounded. They have actually shown themselves to be hollow claims. A small example like what is said to be surgical strike. A border raid is translated into and projected as surgical strike, whereas in military terms, I'm told, and this is what I've read, surgical strike is a much bigger operation and it has a much larger objective than the border raid carried out 700 meters from the fence inside Pakistan's territory, where so-called four launching pads were destroyed and about 30-35 Lashkar terrorists and their handlers were decimated. This is what the Indian force confirmed. My point is that this was in response to what happened in Puri in 2016, September, soon after that. But after that, there were two other raids that have followed. Nagrota camp is deeper inside. It's not even on the LOC. It's much deeper inside. It's headquarters of 16th Corps. Not a brigade headquarters, much higher, where 11 soldiers died. There was no response to that. Sunjuan camp, which was in the early this year attacked, there was no. I think military commanders realized that it's all right for politicians to project something as beyond its limited character for their own political gains. But this is not something that actually serve the objective that the government has set for itself, that it would dissuade Pakistan from undertaking similar such raids inside India. It hasn't prevented. So obviously, if this was supposed to be touted as a success, it's actually not a success. It's a failure that has been touted as success. So how can they use all these disasters in addition to single biggest issue that which people tend to underplay is the role of promotion of Hindutva? much bigger. It has a longer history than 2014. Yeah. But since BJP and Narendra Modi came to power, the openly open manner in which Hindutva forces have operated, it looks patronized and protected by agencies and police department and administration, is something it hasn't paid much dividend. On the contrary, I believe in Jammu and Kashmir, especially in Jammu, the resentment against BJP has grown over the same last 4.5 years.
Okay.
So coming back to your question about 2019, what Kashmir can have, well, it can have a negative impact for BJP because after making those tall promises and tall claims, you find that the results are tiny. In fact, insignificant, if not utter failure.
So thank you, Gautam, for joining us today. And thank you for watching News Click.